Inside the bag, we located the body of Sandra Cantu.
And with those words, the search for 8-year-old Sandra Cantu ended, and the search for whoever killed her has begun. Good morning, I'm Chris Riva.
And I'm Adrienne Bankert. It was the ending no one wanted. Yesterday afternoon, a suitcase containing the body of Sandra Cantu was found at the bottom of an irrigation ditch. We have team coverage this morning, starting with KCRA3's Brian Hickey, live with the latest on the investigation. Brian.
Well, Adrienne, this investigation, now a homicide investigation after what was a search for this 8-year-old girl yesterday, now looking for the search, now the search continuing for the killers of 8-year-old Sandra Cantu. And you can see behind us here the memorial and the folks who've gathered out here this morning to simply say goodbye to this 8-year-old after so many people hung on to hope that this girl would be found. Yesterday, the police department confirming the worst. Take a look at this scene where they found her body. It was just a few miles from her house up off of North Tracy Boulevard near Whitehall Road. Dairy workers were out there draining a pond, using that water to irrigate a nearby field when they noticed a black suitcase. They immediately called police, thinking that this was suspicious. Investigators then surrounded that area and began searching for evidence even before getting the suitcase. They wanted to look for any kind of tire tracks, any kind of footprints, anything that would act as evidence to help them find the killers. Now, investigators spent hours yesterday here at the neighborhood where Sandra Cantu lived, searching that area as well, searching homes. The FBI was here until 3:30 this morning, searching this area along with the church just down the road as they continue their search for evidence. But it was around 9 o'clock last night that the chief of police notified the family and the public that indeed they had found the worst.
Inside the bag, we located the body of Sandra Cantu. Sandra Cantu was positively identified at that point in time. Dr. Omalu of the coroner's office will be conducting an autopsy to determine the cause of death. And our heartfelt sympathies go out to Sandra's family, her friends, and her classmates.
And that autopsy, we're told, will be performed first thing this morning. In the meantime, police continue to guard the gate into Sandra Cantu's neighborhood, only allowing people who live there or have friends there. But beyond that, everyone else being kept out. And we're told that a church right down the road, Clover Road Baptist Church, was searched last night and possibly could be searched again today as the investigators continue to gather their evidence in the search for the killer or killers. In Tracy, Brian Hickey, KCRA 3 reports.
All right, Brian, we'll expect to see more people at that vigil in front of that mobile home park. Thanks so much.
This story certainly has captured the nation's attention. A lot of national headlines. Here's the timeline, the sequence of events on how it unfolded. Sandra disappeared from her home on Friday, March 27th. That led to a massive search effort involving the FBI, police, and hundreds of volunteers. Then on Monday, March 30th, police executed search warrants on 6 different sites in Tracy and Oakdale. Last week, Sandra's father talked to police and took a polygraph test. And yesterday, the large black suitcase was discovered in an irrigation pond about 2 miles from her home. Police announced last night that the body of Sandra Cantu was found inside that luggage.